squad. It'll be Jane Waku who will get the start at setter. Leonidas Kasaya, who's a big hitter as well, gets a start. And she is coming through. Sharon Chumba, of course, is there. Treza Atuka, very distinctive. So that's the starters for Port Betong. Confirmation then with Agrippina Kundu getting the start at libero ahead of Elizabeth Wanyama, although we would expect to see both liberos in action. And he does like to change his personnel, Coach Betong. Now for Japan, Naomi Osaka, the captain, back in the lineup. Course stays there, so it does look like Serena Koga's coming back. Miyasato, Maya Okumura, and Miwako Osanai, and Mayu Ishikawa. Well, that's a bit of a change up from Kumi Nakata. So Serena Koga gets another night off. There's a start from Miwako Osanai. There's another one of these young emerging hitters. Meanwhile, the workload continues for number 28, Mayu Ishikawa. 20 points against Russia, 23 against the United States. Really starting to push for a regular spot in the starting rotation for Japan, teenager. Miyasato, of course, will be pulling all the strings. Kenya looking to salvage a bit of pride here. Opportunities for a win. Starting to run out. Kenya, if they look ahead, we'll see that they've got China tomorrow. They might want to turn up with blindfolds on because they probably won't want to see what's going to happen to them. Here is Japan looking for a return to the winner's enclosure. With Miyasato to get this best of five set match underway. That's a nice confident swing from Sharon Chumba. She's only 20. But she just opens those shoulders up, swings through. She brings a lot of heat. A player with a lot of potential, Sharon Chumba. Waku with serve. And a chance for Osanai. Nice and early. Set they've played in. Almost. Chance for ace there. Marco Cobata, the libero, only just got a piece of that. She cleaning it all up. Really low take there. Off the floor, then. She rubbing it off the block. So on as even the early skirmishes. Nice steady set. And yeah. That's swinging through there from Treza Atuka. Nice service reception, nice comfortable set. Many times you've got the big middle there for the inside take. That's where it needs to go. So, Atuka on the board as well. That's too good far side from Osanai. Who will really look to grab the spotlight as much as she can here. She's been really useful coming in a substitution role. Well, it's quite a spark, something a little bit different to this Japanese on-court presence, but here, getting a start. She'll certainly want to grab this with both hands. It's a beauty, really nice take from Kasaya. But there is contact at the net, I think. And it's called against Chumba. So we'll see what happened here. That's rather a lot of contact, that's a foot fault. Well, the foot going over the centre line. Really winds up the big ball toss, doesn't she, Osamai? That's a wonderful take. Brilliant rescue from Kobata. Ishii will just recycle it. Nothing doing there for Visa, and no first touch available for Ishikawa. And who's just driving through that? With the big youngster, Mayu Ishikawa, getting it right that time. Great dig from Kobata. Ishikawa on the pipe attacks it. Yeah, we'll have that. Chumba also winds it up with the high ball toss. Doesn't put an awful lot of heat on that one. Slip around the backside to just stretch the defences. Now the running attack, which the Japanese do like, and execute it pretty well. Makuto, and there's the running attack, and blocked out of it. That's a nice play by Leonida Kasaya there. Yeah, he likes what he's seeing here. Positive start. It's high Japan, of course, defensively, they bring so much back. They're not bringing that back. Kasaya with the block point. It's gone off at a slightly strange angle, but it's controllable. Creative hit from Ishikawa. Certainly off to a quick one here. Moeen's cross court not good enough. The block's good enough. Moeen might have not got the kill. With a cross court, but Edith Visa has got the block point. The big, in fact, it's that was Mercy Moeen alongside of it will get the decisive touch. Well, Japan's big vulnerability is to block points. Every team that faces them ranks up block points. Cameroon did it in Yokohama. Kenya have a couple here, but it's Japan. Okay, slip the lead into the first technical timeout. Thank you. Kenyans. Eventually, Chimba reeling in. Tell us. Oh, look at that. Naoki Osaka. Full stretch. Sharks getting a bit of contact. So that's a great challenge. Michael Peter. Bring Jane Waku up to serve. Can you get this deficit back under control? Ishikawa then. Mid serve next. That'll be good. Unfortunately for Kenya, it's not. This is going to get over from Oe. For a middle blocker. Oh, mercy, Moe. It's easy like ace there. Ishikawa. Now he's really starting to wreak some havoc with these serves of hers now. Teenager again. Lots of variety. That was almost another race. The creative chaos. Kenya coming apart at the seams here. Shumba decided to be positive, which is a good thing. You've got to bring it in play as well. Well, Ishikawa was certainly getting quite a workout on her serving arm here. A much better take. Another typical rescue from the libero Kobata. Chumba does finish that one. There's a dig there. That one's coming back well, nicely played. Yeah, and at the right to be in this point. There's some nice dinking and dunking going on. eventually. Kuta says, yeah, I'll take that one, thank you very much. But they need a big fight back from here already. Mercy Moeen serving Ishii. That'll go down the backside. Yeah, that may well have dropped in. Well taken, really important take there for Agrippina. Agrippina Kundu, the libero. Makuto with a finishing touch. The quick set, but that was all well and in the back hole there. Here is Makuto serving at 9:15. She got a winner there. Sneaky on backside, read all the way by Mai Okamura, and then is she just enough to take Japan to the second technical timeout. That run of points on the Ishikawa serve. Oh, it's very, very hard for Kenny to pull back. This is already looking at a tall order for Paul Pitok and his players. They will face Cameroon later in the competition, and that could be a dress rehearsal for a place at the Olympics, because one of Cameroon, Kenya, or Egypt will be going to represent Africa in Tokyo next summer. Cameroon probably the favourites. This is a regular substitution. And a player coming in, Haruka Miyashita. Backup center coming in to take care of serving. Well, this is something that shows up in every match for Japan. I know what's coming, Kenya. I've just got to deal with it. Much better take. Kabata's been having some fun out there the last couple of days. Keeping a lot of points alive. Wasn't going to keep that one alive. Now we are seeing four changes. And a rare appearance here for Immaculate Chemu, who is on court along with Janet Wanja. One veteran setter swapped out for another by Paul Pitok. And there is Chemu, who has been used very sparingly. That's a brilliant rescue again from Kundu. She's having quite a game. Immaculate Chemu, that would have been quite an introduction if she could have just guided this in. That's wonderful stuff from Kundu. That was almost a winning introduction off the bench for Chemu. Almost, but not quite. Reception's pretty good. Anita Fisa is going to bury that. I'm going to take it nice and high. That was easy. like that for Edith Visa. Mapea with the push. Really nice rescue. And I think Kundu was involved in that. It's down the line for Mercy Bowie. She's not brought her A game. The Kenyan captain. A few miscues she's had now. In a bunch of trouble here in this first set. All trouble here off that netcourt skimmer. Chemu can't find a winner. Napea will go cross court. There is definitely some sort of contact on the net there. Picked up by the hawkish eyes of Karina Rene, who misses nothing in the chair. All switching up. Now for Angby. Second time was the charm. Kasaya thought she got a winner first time. He came back first touch. Visa, quite some fun up at the net. Getting it right at the second. A 10-foot court with a wonderful dig. First time around. Kenya weren't going to be denied twice, so Visa will stay back at the baseline for this next point. Uh-oh. Oh, well, well. This is she. Getting the wires crossed. Service at section either in Japan. Pretty loose volleyball just at the moment. That is wonderful stuff from Kobato. Looks like another big swing from Kasaya. And Japan. Another big swing there. Let's find that rescue. It's just another miss. This is not a good spell. Japanese were allowing Kenya to claw their way back into this. That's coming back on first touch. So Nabea will have another go. That's not coming back. That's like that. Safe serve, but not exactly what it deserves. Smash back. So the rotation complete. Ruby Ricardo will now revert to her base on court. Sato comes back in to handle setting duties. Osanai back out there as well, and it's Osanai who's receiving here, and there's Ishii driving through. Another great bit of defensive work from Kasaya to keep it alive. And they can transition out here, Kenya. And they do nicely. Morambi, a lovely cross court. Kenya continue to close the gap here. Well, this is really good stuff. We saw an earlier match in this competition when the Dominican Republic went 2-0 up against Cameroon. That ended up going 5. If you disregard an opponent at this level, you're probably going to pay for it. Japan need to wake up. Five more shots like that. For Ishikawa, get back. Down to business. Should be very comfortable in this set. Should mop it up pretty comfortably. Kumi Nakai will be saying, let's just clean things up a little bit here. Don't take any opponent lightly. This is the World Cup. Anybody can come and get you. Clever second touch. Doesn't quite work. Or does it? No, they'll get a second bite of it. High attack. Oh, that's a shame. Kumi Nakai was taking evasive action there. to side, look for the edge. She's coming in. Here she comes. Watch out, Kumi, that's coming at you. Like they've weathered that little Kenyan rally here as far as the first set is concerned. Japan tough to get a winner from there on the 3 meter line. Ishii has to recycle this one. It's another go. Sends it too long. Well, Kenyan's resolute defending forces the error. Question block touch on that. Available underneath. See, when they catch them clean, these Kenyan hitters really do bring some singers. That's Kasaya again. That's up there.
Serving number three, fire.
that set by the numbers then? Blocks for Kenya. No surprise there, just the one ace. But it's the attack hitting that is working out for Japan. Ishikawa prominent, Asanai chipping in. And Ishii really is handling a heavy load here in this World Cup. Also prominent among the scorers. Center contact point will tell you a lot. If that's around 75-80%, you're doing okay. So Kenya have got their veteran centers scrambling around a little bit, got to help those old legs out. Whereas for Japan, it's a much cleaner path. High 70s, that's acceptable, could be better. Japan will be looking to improve that if they possibly can. Underway then. Japan one set to the good. Asanai can't find a winner there. Waku is scrambling around again. Such a busy set. Asanai has another go. That's coming back. Lovely dig from Visa back there. And there is a whistle there. So Serena Koga comes off the bench. Haven't seen much of Serena at all up until now. Sapporo. Well, you're bringing in a fresh hitter like Koga. It's almost cruel for Kenya to have to try and deal with that. Sato slings it backside. Well, Asanai drives it cross court. Beautiful. Terrific execution. Chances and shuffle the deck a little bit, keep players fresh. But a big one tomorrow night. Brazil. Oh, that's just about gone through. Well, Mercy Bowie, some real ups and downs in Kenyan women's volleyball at the moment. Get a bit of everything. Waku with the net serve. Koga. Oh, that's a beauty. That's an absolute beauty from Sharon Chumba. Look, you look at a swing like this, and you can see why people talk about the 20-year-old's potential. I mean, you can't play it any better than that. On first touch, complete mess there for Japan. Koga messing that up. Koga will look to clean up her own mess and does. Well, Serena Koga was the workhorse against the Dominican Republic much earlier in the competition with Japan. She ranked up 28 points, grinding Japan over the line in a four-set victory, but has been played sparingly since. Of Miwako Osana and Yamamoto Ishikawa in particular a chance to get some good playing time. Not that hit from the side. Some of this hitting from the Kenyans, and we've seen it before, is pretty ferocious. Kasaya Chumba, Marambi, Makuto, they really swing through. So at stretch brings Koga into play. Ooh. A little bit close there, Nakamura. Where's that going? Sato's not sure, so you claim it. Koga, really nice work in the backcourt from Mercy Moeen there. There's another big swing throughs from Kasaya. Oh, really good rally that. Really good rally. It's not one of those points where you look at Kenya when they're playing solid D like this. Not necessarily say they're going to beat some of the top teams in the world, but they can be competitive. Can they be competitive more consistently? Rescue that situation. Yeah, the early breakthrough here for Japan. Nothing doing for Visa there. So, that's a night. Drills one in. It's coming back. See what Visa say. Yeah, really? You're going to give it to me on first touch? I don't think so. Oh, absolutely no chance. Miyasa. Sato trying to get the block there. That's not going to happen. Kenya doing everything they can to stick around here. Just trying to power their way through this one. That'd be power. Any placement. Okamura demonstrates here off the running attack. Their way. No, they're not. challenge that? We got the answer. Oh, there's a case here for this to be looked at again, that's for sure. Play will resume with Sato serving then. Big swing from Chumba, picked up backcourt, and then there's the block. Visa seems to be involved in a lot of good stuff for Kenya in this match. There she is again, the number 19 middle blocker. There she's patrolling. It wasn't her this time, it was Mercy Bowie right alongside her. But Visa's presence has caused Japan some problems. Finished at just after 10 o'clock local time. Might have taken something out of the legs, but a lot of these players didn't play a lot in that match. Sato did. He'll send it back to Ishii. He definitely did. And they're not winning that match. Side, nothing there for Osanai. Not be much there at all. The big, big swinging Kenyan, that was Kasaya again. Now, Kasaya's default position is go for it. You can't fault that. And that one just a little bit too deep. She's sneaky. With a free hit. She sends it deep as well, so Kenya draws themselves level. Then let it slip away again, so timeout time for Paul Vito. Thank you. Osaka, the veteran captain. Service reception wasn't particularly good there, but they get away with it. Crushing point. These are sort of little jewels that I usually find a way to recycle. Keep the rally going on. Mercy Moe winning that duel at the net up against two would-be blockers. Good luck bringing that one back. Serena Koga should be fresh. Koga should be bringing an awful lot of heat here by now. When she gets going, she's such a lovely technician. She's going to find a lot of clean kills. Hustled out of it far side, she'll have another go there. That's a beautiful angle. Koga taking this one on. A couple of big blockers in there as she does fire parking beautifully. Lovely angle from Koga. She'll now serve with Japan looking to just edge ahead a little bit. Kasai's just rather hung up this one. She'll go for that even though it's beyond the 3 meter line. Picked up. Picked up. Straight down Main Street goes Serena Koga on the bar attack. Watch her, there she is. Here she goes, making the move. Time to jump right, swings through. See you later. She doesn't look too pleased about that, does she? Well, we're going to challenge it. It has caught the line, it's only just caught it, only just, of course, is good enough. Whether she's nicked it or not, that swing didn't look particularly impressive from the previous one, even less so. Anything there for Ishii? Just. Well, that'll take Japan to the second technical timeout. I think Kamina Carter is hugely impressed with what she's seeing out there at the moment, but Japan have the set, they have the lead. checking in for my reporter. Coach Nakata continues to freshen up the on-court personnel. So everyone's going to get a workout today. Wanja sends that backside. Kasaya, though, can't find a winner this time. Sato goes backside as well. Osamai, too good. She'll go back to the bullpen. Looks like she was just brought in for a serve there. Now Japan continuing to edge ahead here. No winner again for Ishii. Mercy Noreen does find a winner. That took as many touches as he liked. One in the net, one in the backcourt. Nobody is getting that under control. Really nice big hit from the Kenyan captain. And he's staying in touch here. Now if they get a point on serve, this becomes too close to call. Now, plenty of air under it. Oga. Five attacks. Sato with serve, serving Kundu. Beautiful take from Kundu, an easy put away. Now Wanja's set was nice. It's his finish. It was beautiful. He's had some big points in this match. They look to try and level this set up. Much better take second time around. And that was like, no, you are not going to draw level with us. We won't go Osanai. No block there. Nobody home. So Japan should be able to see this out from here, as if she sends another one in. Morambi. So I might have been better leaving that for Sato, but you have to make these decisions in a nanosecond. And the side out sends Chemu back to the service line. Again, not great. Yamagisha. Where's that going? Oh, grief. What was Sato doing there? Oh, that really was a scruffy point. All over the place on that one, Japan. That's a missed opportunity for Kenya, and he knows it. Just a punch of net there. Of that. Hey! Osaka goes wide. No way. Violet Makuta gets them to stop that. This one down right here to secure a two-set advantage. Oh, sneaked over the net there. Yeah. Once Kasai started lining that one up, it was like head for the shelters. There's something coming in. Well, there's a typhoon due here in the early hours of the morning. Well, I'm not sure it can wreak as much havoc as Leonida Kasai did with that swing. So Kenya staying alive here with Makuto serving. Nabea. Brilliant pick up from Morambi. Absolutely wonderful. Kasai's going to go again. Does it again. Eye-catching little performance, this, from Leonida Kasai. It's as nice as you like. That's one set point save. Makuto, going to try and save another one here. Koga picks that one up. Nabea's blocked out of it. They're making very hard work of this. Japan, that's Visa again. She's not very impressed, does she? Calls a timeout, Kuki Nakata. Take nothing away from Kenya's fighting spirit, but with Japan, who seem intent on doing this the hard way here, don't they? Still set point then. Kuto with serve. Trying to save another one here. They won't do it. That's enough of that. Fujigawa. Again, not exactly eye-catching, dazzling stuff. But enough to get the job done. 25-22. That's as many points as Kenji have managed in a set this whole competition. Is Serena Koga off the bench and into double figures, the only player with a double-digit tally, 10 points. It's matches, hasn't it, where no one player has stood out. There are lots of substitutions on both sides of the net. Well, let's have a look at what's been going on. The set of contact points for Japan. Nothing particularly special that. Even less so for Kenya. Set. Well, this year's World Cup goes on. This is close as they've come, though, in that last set. A Japan squad that doesn't quite have the sharpness that we saw yesterday. They're still good enough to play in the first two sets here. You do wonder if that five-set of deep into the night has had an effect on Japan. It almost certainly had an effect on the United States. Never got close. 31-sided sets against China earlier today. Their recovery time clearly affected. Nevertheless, Japan do have the first two sets. Let's see if Kenya can finally end their drought. Right here, Morambi not handling that particularly brilliantly. That's a pick-up from Kogan. And then she goes across court and misses. So all the Japanese players are having a look as if to say, did that take a touch? That certainly produced a reaction from Kumi Nakada. Did stick a finger out there, Noel Morambi, as that was going through. Certainly the reaction of the Japanese players was in unison. They expected this call to go their way. In fact, they're looking at the in-out. Oh, that's why. Clearly. So Japan off to an early flyer here. Sato will serve. Morambi has picked off nicely. The cross-court pick-up from Ishii, who will look to bury it, but her cross-court is picked up as well by Kundu, who's played really well defensively for Kenya. And then the drive through. Easily Kenya's most consistent hitter. Step it up, grabbing a piece of that one. It's really nice from Kasaya. Again, good work from the libero Kundu. So Kenya's best defensive player and best offensive player combining there. That's a nice take from Sato in second touch. That really is reaching backwards one-handed. Still manages to toss it up there. And now Iwasaka to bury it. Quick set. Players at this level do make that look easy, but there's a lot of technique in that. Is she? Uh-oh, where's this going? Oh, and that was a really nice take from Jane Waku. Well, anything you can do one-handed. Jane Waku can do one-handed as well. Really important set this, because that's traveling. Waku's only got one option here. Just flick it up for the big middle. Kuto did the rest. And that's a nice pickup. Chumba, nothing doing for her there, but no, there was no second touch. Can take that. Kenya storming back here in the early stages of this third set. Where's that going? Back on the Japanese side, Kogan can't find a winner. Now Waku's looking around, got all kinds of options going on here. Morambi almost taking out the libero there, and then a clever little pick to finish off with. Big pick up there from Akane Yamagisha. Here it is. Wow. Took that really high. Sire couldn't get there, low down. Koga keeps churning him out. Shumba. Right. She looks for transition out. It's a good. Kasai might have been impressing with some formidable hitting, but that's a couple of times she's had a tough ball. Not an attempted defensive pickup. That cross court would have been very hard to get. Couldn't get any control on it. So Japan edge back in front here. This third set. Osaka's serve is sent back. She'll turn setter here. And that's going over and out from Kawaka Masano. Beatoff has to not so much call timeout as press the panic button here. Timeout. Osaka will continue serve, and that's what you want to see. You call the timeout. You want to see a response. So you need a Kasai coming up with another big one. This isn't coming back. Well, who's on the other side of the net? That is not coming back. The blockers unable to get there together. A huge gap for Kasai to exploit. And a lovely trajectory on that ball. No dig available from the backcourt on that one. Nothing was coming back off that one either from Kitagawa. This is better play on both sides in this third set. Really good execution. Terrific length. Let's see if Osanai can take Japan to the first technical timeout here. On serve. Going for the big one. Winding it up. Morambi had a bit of trouble with that. Visa can't find a winner. Slipping around the backside. Osanai very hot. And they'll just recycle their Kenya. Options for Sato. Backside. A good guard. No. Brilliantly kept alive by Waku. My goodness me. That was a dead ball all the way. So Kudagawa has another go. That doesn't work. So she has another go and finally gets there. But spare a thought for Kenya. They put everything into a full-blooded defense there. Jane Waku might have been a bit lucky, but you make your luck. And then they kept defending and defending. And Kudagawa just kept swinging and swinging. Got there in the end. go then. 8-4 Japan leading here in this third set. Osanai winding up another one. That's a nice take from Morambi, a really good take. And here goes Kasai again, but the block has done its job. Koga can't get a winner. Iwasaka shuts that over. Tempo really picked up in this third set. There's a beautiful block from Visa. That's a lovely point again, both sides. This is much better to see. Here's that usual double substitution. Rancher coming in. The service line. Chanu joining up. Koga with a nice comfortable take. There's the 5-10. That's not coming back. Ishii pulling the trigger to perfection. Well, this is better. It's just better all around. The last few points, the quality of play on both sides has just leapt up. Koga then will serve at 9-5. A nice take again from Kundu. Can't play much better than that. And a beautiful put away from Visa. Yeah, this is just good execution. It's pretty simple and it's pretty basic, but you're still going to join the dots up. Kenny did it absolutely right there. Service reception perfect again from Kundu. He's had quite a game defensively for Kenya. His big hitting Kasaya. Sending that one. Touch on the way through. Much more sharpness around the service receptions. The points are getting shorter as a result. The hitting's looking better. The whole tempo of this third set producing a lot more sharpness from both teams. Kutagawa now sending that one away. Morambi, who's had one or two wobbles over the course of her World Cup journey on service reception, had another big wobble there. Paul Vitok is going to shuffle the deck again. There's movement. Mercy Marine is looking poised to come back in. Won't come in yet. Kagawa will stay at the service line. Again, Kundu handles it beautifully. Wonderful pickup there from Osanai. And here's Ishii. Just about speeding one through there. Visa were there together, and here is the return of the Kenyan skipper. Morambi will come out after that miscue on service reception. Japan now starting to open up serious daylight between the two teams. Tough to see Kenya finding a way back into this third set, even this early. Kutagawa serves Moeen. Handles it nicely. Visa is not taking any chances. Just flying through here. Look at that. A much needed side out for Kenya, for whom Visa will now send in a high one. Sato goes backside. Koga arrives it off the block. And happy to side out from here. Never quite got the trajectory she was looking for there, Sato. That was heading for the net, and the moment it left the hand. Now Loreen comes in. It's another new face then for Paul Vitok. There's only a couple of players on his squad that have not seen any playing time today. So none of his players can look at the coach and say, well, you never gave me a chance. He's given everybody some air time here. 14-8 up. Oh, Tucker and Koga, but they knew they weren't getting anywhere near that. Side out. That's a nice rescue. Look at that from Chemu. Wonderful dig there. And they get the point off it. No, they don't. It has taken a time. Oh, I thought it's a miracle. Defensive play here was going to produce a point. Wonderful dig from Chemu. Approach the second technical timeout. Kundu handles that one brilliantly. The side drills it deep. On the block. Much better this time. But still absolutely wiped out. What a big swing from Leonida Kasaya. Two minds there, and I think Peter got in the way of Janet Wanger a little bit as well. So big breakdown there. I haven't seen too many technical breakdowns from Kenya in this third set. It's been a much sharper performance from them. Unfortunately, for Paul Beatoff's players, it's been a lot better from Japan as well. In the house tomorrow night. She wants to get out of here at the earliest. A rare pickup of a Kasaya swing there. It's just a push from Chemu. She could do no more. And there's the block from Visa. They'll send it up to Nevaeh, and that's coming back. Well, you can do all the dinky-doo stuff as much as you like, but eventually you are going to pay for it. And absolutely zero conviction from Nevaeh. That wasn't going to beat anybody. Wanger sends that one in. Kenya looking to mount the big comeback, and that was so much better for you from Urena Nevaeh. Wearing the protective goggles. Saw this one early. Buried it inside. Koga's serve, and Visa will send that back for the interest again. Really nice take. Sometimes it's a really simple game. You handle service reception well. It's amazing how often you got to win the point. Really drilled that one. That's a beauty. Absolute beauty. beauty from Ishii. Absolutely low. A double boom on that one, didn't she? Last time Akutagawa came up to serve, Kenya couldn't get her off the service line. 4 or 5 points in a row. Absolutely sealed that second set, and there might be a chance of this. That's a wonderful rescue. Brilliant bit of work from the setter, Wancha. One-handed as well, with only one possible option available. Hang it up there for the big middle coming through. Well, she couldn't have played it much better than that. These have just gobbled it up. But all the hard work done there by Janet Wancha. That's the Akutagawa serve. Serve gone. Visa. A player. Yeah, that's more like it. Killer cross ball there from Yurie the player. Underneath it, but can Japan capitalize? They can scrap it, but it was effective on Iwasaka. Decisive touch down the middle. Well, this one winding down now. Vitok has a timeout, decides he might as well take it right here. Something that didn't work. Watch out, Kasaya driving through. Nice pickup from the Bayer. Talk about driving through, but not driving through effectively. It's a missed opportunity. Real surprise there that Serena Coker has sent that one as long as she has. Multiple substitutions on both sides of the net. As we get down to the last rights of this one. Waku back on, serving. Wonderful pickup again from Kundo, who's been superb. And Kasaya brilliantly sent back that one. Absolutely super stuff. And then the big miss. What a pickup from Akana Yamagisha, the libero for Japan, on that huge swing. And then, having done all the hard work, Sharon Chumba, who's just come off the bench, to be fair to her, gets the swing all wrong. So she tried to be sneaky. Everybody back deep. Would have been interesting if that had cleared, wouldn't it? See the thinking. Moeem safely taken and safely dispatched on the far side. Waku Hosanai, important pick up there from Yamagisha, the libero again. once that was in play, everything else should have been easy enough. Not the greatest swing in this match from Ossanai, but it had just enough on it. Iwasaka up to serve, here comes Kasai. Got a good block on there, Japan. They'll drive it back in deep, and that's too good. Too good. Busiboe getting rid of some frustration there. Started when so many of these Kenyan players got benched. He really does shuffle everybody around, Paul Beetock. That desperate search to find the winning blend. Content of the net or centre line fault, either way. It's a point against Kenya. Takes Japan one step closer. Miwako Ossanai serving at 23-16. Really winding that one up. That's a tough take for Chumba. Couldn't really get anything on that at all. Misato didn't get much on that one either. Koga, that's spun off Moeen, but she's done enough to keep it alive. And Chumba, this goes for the little push. And the push is the only available option there for Ossanai, and she pushed it into her own net. To this one, it's Koga, the match's top scorer, looking to tack on another point here. Oh, that's coming straight back from Edith Fieser. Absolutely drilled that. Kenya's top scorer makes Japan wait. Got everything on that, Fieser. She's had a very solid. She and Kasaya have hit really well for Kenya today, not had enough support really. Here is Kasai, and that's coming over, and they get away with one there, Japan. This one's coming over. Duel of the net is won by Kenya. The wait goes on. Is that Fieser again? Suddenly there. Suddenly they're springing back to life here, Kenya. Surely they can't bring this back, though. Kasai. That's going to be a big, big headache here for Japan. They'll hoist it back over, but Waku has got all day to make a decision. And that's 3 points they've saved. And Kenya Nakata is getting a bit annoyed about this. That's the what's going on timeout. Rescuing this. Kasai sends that one in. That's nicely taken. That should be the end of it, but it's not. Kasai gets underneath that one. Moeen with the swing. Now Japan looking to set up. And finally, Aika Akutagawa closes the book on this one. It's all over. As expected, a straight sets victory for Japan. Kenya competitive, particularly in that messy second set. Well, they clawed their way to 22 points. A flash of defiance at set point down from Kenya. Put a bit of gloss on the scoreline as well, but it was always just a question of how quickly Japan would get through this one. You do wonder if there was a slight reaction from the exertions of last night, that draining 5-7 along into the night. And with fresh legs out there, a lot of players, a lot of the stars of yesterday rested, there can really be no excuses for Japan. And I'm sure they won't make any either. Kenya still await, never mind their first win, they still await their first set. As it is, Japan back in the winner's enclosure. They could turn their attentions to Brazil, because if they can push the United States to the limit, a Brazil team that is quite clicking at the moment could be there for the taking. Be a tall surprise to see a long match to close tomorrow night out. But that's for another day. Today, they can celebrate a World Cup win. And they don't come along all the time. It's nice to see the Kenyans want to share the moment as well. They've certainly been very, very welcome in Japan. Really being embraced by some of the other teams. So, a shared group photo. That's nice. Well, the match was, of course, played in good spirit, as most volleyball matches.